What would you say if I were to told you that Elon Musk has unveiled a warp drive that would make it possible to travel to Mars on a much reduced time trip of like 1 month as opposed to the 5 months that you originally know of? Interesting, right? Well, stay tuned so you don't miss out on all the information. Today, I'm going to be talking about the recently unveiled warp drive by Elon Musk and how fast it can help Musk to actualize his dream of people living on Mars. I don't know if you watched any of my previous videos on what life in Elon Musk's Mars colony will be like. If you haven't, please click on the link showing in the top right corner of your screen to stay updated. So, in my previous video, I talked about how Musk intends on actualizing his dream of people living on Mars, but the shortest time it would take to travel to Mars is 5 months, and even at that, it would have to be once every 2 years. Well, Musk has been working hard to find a solution to this problem, and the solution is a warp drive. We know that Musk is eager and desperate for his spaceship to be done as soon as possible because he wants to start sending astronauts to Mars by 2026, and not 2033 as NASA proposes. If he is to do this, then he has just 4 years left to make this possible, or worst case scenario by 2031, which is 9 years left and 2 years earlier than NASA intends. The warp drive technology didn't just come into place now though. Musk has been connected to warp drive technology for a long time now, but I guess he just didn't focus on this technology. Neil deGrasse Tyson, who is a famous scientist, even took to Twitter one time urging Musk to concentrate more on developing the warp drive technology rather than the rockets, Hyperloop electric trucks, and Neuralink. He may not have been serious with this request, but Musk took it seriously and responded that setting up a city on Mars and regularly commuting between Earth and Mars will be a powerful driving force for inventing the warp drive. To comprehend how the warp drive technology would work, let's start with explaining the warp drive's theory. The theory is basically about bending time and space with enough energy. You can bend time and space with enough energy. Sadly, we don't have a spaceship capable of doing this yet, but we do have a ship that could bend space and time. But if we had a ship that could bend time and space, warp drive, then we could travel to the stars in a matter of weeks instead of millions of years. Now, to the question of the day. How exactly would the warp drive technology work? Well, the idea is to compress the space between you and the planet you want to go to. This can be done by creating a bubble of flat space-time around the spaceship and curving space-time around the bubble to reduce distances. So technically, it would be like you are not going to the star or whichever planet you would want to go to. The star would come to you instead. I should tell you that it's not as easy as it sounds. There are certain problems associated with how this drive would work. One is the problem of how to stop traveling faster than the speed of light and return to flat when you reach your destination. Not to mention, Hawking radiation would bombard any travelers in a bubble of warp drive. Some people have said that some propellant in the bubble might still be needed. There is also a problem of no one knowing how to produce such negative large energy, because for you to be able to compress or warp space-time, you need negative energy. A warp drive would use an amount of mass to create an imbalance between particles and antiparticles. This imbalance would now result in negative energy density and create the space-time bubble. The major and sad part about this, though, is how to produce negative energy. The amount of mass needed to create negative energy is impractical, because if, for instance, you want to create a 100-meter bubble, you would need the mass of an entire universe, and if this happens, where would you and I live? There seems to be hope, however, because a psychiatrist, Erik Lentz, has published a paper that kind of offers a solution to the problem of the need for negative energy. In his paper, he showed how positive energy is enough to create a warp drive bubble if you take advantage of hyperbolic space-time rather than linear. Following this, a warp drive wouldn't need to use negative energy. Lentz described how a warp drive might work by using a concept called a soliton, which travels as a wave function in space-time. In contrast to Alkubierre's theory, where the universe is expanded behind the ship and contracted in front of it, in Lentz's theory, both expansion and contraction take place around and in all directions of the soliton entity. The soliton itself is curved space-time, which remains stable through the process. But quick question though, if it were possible to generate a sufficient amount of energy for a warp drive, what would that mean for the traveler? Well, according to Erik Lentz, no time paradoxes would occur. If a person traveled for 9 years to Earth to Proxima Centauri, for instance, the same amount of time would have passed on Earth as on the spacecraft, because of the lack of acceleration experienced by the space travelers. Of course, many questions remain, but the physicist Erik Lentz has found a solution to the biggest problem, the need for negative energy. Now that we're done with discussing how the warp drive technology would work, let's move to how fast the warp drive spaceship is going to be to enable it to travel space very fast. To answer this, I'm very excited to tell you that the warp drive can go more quickly than the speed of light. That should tell you that this is insanely fast. Let's use an illustration of the star to explain how fast for better understanding. Have you heard of the Proxima Centauri star? Well, it is one of the nearest stars to us. If we were to use the rockets we have today, it would be between 17 million 78,000 years away from Earth. But then, if it were to be a warp drive spaceship, it would take less than 4 years to get there. Technically speaking, this warp drive spaceship would solve a huge number of problems Musk has had to deal with. One of which is that volunteers can quickly return to Earth if they change their minds about going to Mars. Another, which is probably the most important, is that it would reduce health risks. Originally, to go to Mars, you would need a budget for at least 5 months of your life, which is a long time. The 5 months could stretch to a year depending on when you take off. Imagine staying that long in microgravity conditions. It would have a physical and mental toll on you. You could end up losing bone density. The bones in your pelvic area would be affected. You could even get kidney stones and lose some of your bones' ability to heal. All these would be a result of the fact that your muscle mass and strength would reduce, making you weaker. You would also have to contend with radiation, and I'm talking about a lot of radiation, because we have a lot of that in deep space. It becomes worse if the spacecraft is not properly shielded. I mean, worse to the fact that you could go sterile. The more time you spend in space increases the chance of things going wrong, so the goal should always be to spend as little time as possible in space, and this is why the warp drive technology would be very helpful. Imagine if there was no warp technology and 100 people were to go to Mars. They would spend 5 months or more in the spaceship, the fights that could break out. All of it sounds like a big catastrophe, and that is why Musk desperately wants to reduce the time of the trip to Mars to a month or less. I'm curious to know, is this the first time you're hearing about warp technology? Please let me know in the comments section, and I'll be on the lookout. We have come to the end of this video sadly, but I hope you enjoyed it. Tell me what you think about all I've said in the comments section, because I'm always eager to hear your thoughts. Also, would you like to go to Mars using this warp drive spaceship? Let me know by giving this video a like. See you in the next video.